Hello. The case that I decided to look at this week was Rodgers v. Georgia Technical Athletics Association. This case is from 1983 and actually goes to the Georgia Appellate Court because the original case that was being heard did not rule in the favor of the plaintiff. Rodgers. This is a case that is involving Pepper Rodgers, the former head football coach of Georgia Tech University, and he was suing the Georgia Tech Athletic Association for compensation of fringe benefits that he should have received in his termination as head coach of the football program. The background to the case, Pepper Rodgers was contracted to become the head football coach at Georgia Tech in the winter of 1978 to coach from 1978 to 19, or sorry, 1973 to 1971. It was a 3-year contract that instated certain benefits to Rodgers and his family, including the health benefits, life insurance policies, and of course, there were other fringe benefits that were instilled into the contract that when the board decided to terminate Rodgers as the head coach, he was filing a lawsuit to try and get more, or at least try to get the compensation for those benefits that were instilled into the contract. Now, in the winter of 1978, or sorry, 1979, the board met at their annual meeting in December and decided that they would not have Rodgers be the head coach any longer at Georgia Tech. With the termination of Rodgers, he felt that it was in his contract that he would receive compensation for those fringe benefits that were put into place. Now, in the case, he decides to divide up the two types of benefits that he received while as a head coach of the Georgia Tech football team. Now, one of those groups were more of the administrative type of benefits, dealing with how to run the program efficiently and getting what needed to be done with the football team done in an efficient manner. That included the use of a secretary, an administrative assistant, paying for the trips to go to football clinics and other educational resources, conferences around the country. Most of those were given to Rodgers as compensation when his resignation was, or sorry, when his position was terminated. But the ideas of being compensated for the use of a secretary and administrative assistant were not, because that is something that was given to him when he was the head coach. Because he was no longer the head coach, he was not given any of that compensation. Now, the second group was the fringe benefits that were divided or developed and given to the head coach while he was the head coach. Now, Rodgers would receive a lot of these benefits from outside sources, and he was claiming that because he received these gifts from outside sources, he needed to be compensated through the university. So things like membership fees being paid for at country clubs, various country clubs around the city of Atlanta, and tennis clubs around the city of Atlanta, the benefits being paid to a $400,000 life insurance policy for him, the use of a brand new Cadillac. Because he was being terminated of this position as head coach, he would no longer receive those benefits through the alumni or through being head coach of the football team. The courts, original court, decided to rule in favor of Georgia Tech Athletic Association, saying that they did not have any contractual evidence to have to compensate Pepper Rodgers for his remaining time as head coach on the contract, because the contract did run through 1981. Now, of course, Rodgers appeals the case, and the appellate court of the district in which it is heard decides to reverse the decision of the lower court in parts of the compensation, and of course not reverse the decision of the lower court in other parts of the compensation. So, for instance, the tickets that were given to Rodgers for the Braves baseball games, the Atlanta Hawks basketball games, the Atlanta Falcons football games, that was not compensated for his termination. The use of the brand new car, the benefits being paid to a $400,000 life insurance policy was not being compensated to Rodgers, because those the use of the car and the insurance policy, that was already discontinued before his termination of being head coach. And so the court decided that it was not any longer needed to be benefiting the coach. Use of the country club and the tickets, those were from outside sources that were no longer given to Rodgers because he was no longer the football coach. The courts decided that because it was no longer, it had nothing to do with the Athletic Association, there was nothing that they needed to compensate him for. So all in all, this was more of a split decision in a way, because yes, Rodgers is compensated for his the rest of his contract, being paid $35,000, roughly about $35,000, $36,000 for the remainder of his contract, which would be 1980 and 1981, and also being compensated for the benefits that were written into the contract. The fringe benefits, however, so for instance, the payments of the country clubs and the use of the brand new car, any outside profit that he would receive through television or radio programs was not compensated, because those are obviously things that could be given to him in a different amount each year. And the courts decided that it was no real true evidence of how much to be compensating Rodgers. And so in a way, it was kind of a split decision to decide who or what is being paid out to Rodgers, and how much would be paid to him. Thank you.